The Bionic company is the emergence of a new business paradigm, one where business and technology come together in a much more integrated manner than we're used to. We see this across sectors and geographies, and the way our clients express it is that they are becoming a tech company. This new paradigm is brought about by two major changes happening around us. First, it's the increasing pace of innovation. The time to market and the sort of the speed of change is simply accelerating. And so there, for companies, there is a larger need to continuously reevaluate their priorities and how they serve the markets. The second big change is the role of technology. Technology is no longer for tech companies. It's becoming an essential part of all companies and how they actually deliver services or values to their customers. And the combination of those two changes is what's bringing about this new paradigm. In the old business paradigm, business and IT live a separate life. IT is often treated as an internal service provider at arm's length from the business, often outsourced and not co-located with the rest of the business. The business function, on the other hand, is often unaware of the benefits technology can bring to the business in order to advance the objectives of the business, and nobody wants to partake in long IT projects. Luckily, that is changing. In the new paradigm, business and technology are coming together in a much more integrated manner, and in that way are able to faster, better meet the needs of the business. And that's what we at BCG call the Bionic company. It consists of four core components. First, it's a product and capability-centric view of the organization. So you take a step away from the old business units of functional siloed view of how you deliver value and look at what are the capabilities that a business has to deliver value. Second, it's the digital data platform architecture. It's a step away from the old monolithic IT architecture where data and business logic is integrated into old core systems and take a much more data-centric view of the organization. Third, it's a ways of working. Agile is the one that has been getting most attention the recent years, and you know, most companies have done their pilots. But if you really want to unlock the responsiveness of the organization, you need to deal with three additional changes. One of them is around funding, one of them is around prioritization, and one of them is around governance. The fourth and last component is upskilling. And this is probably the most important one. It's about how you, on both the technology and the business side, can reskill, upskill, and hire new talent in order to bring the capabilities to the table that it needed in order to deliver the value. And it's important to take an integrated view on these four components. Many companies have done experiments and pilots in one of them or parts of them, but few have taken that total view on the integrated business system that needs to change. And it's only in taking the integrated view that you'll create the unlock.